Some village in the Philippines seeking help from police after receiving death threats ahead of the village and youth council elections in October. That's according to PNP Chief Benjamin Accorda Jr. Accorda assures the officials the police will keep them safe once the threats are proven. He adds they will monitor the movement of left-wing militant groups to prevent any election disruption.
This early, we do not foresee any serious peace and order concerns on a national scale in the 2023 BSKE. The actions of some remaining active guerrilla fronts of the CPP-NPA are closely being monitored for possible conduct of atrocities.
The Philippines seeks to increase the number of its peacekeeping forces ahead of its bid for a seat in the United Nations Security Council for years 2027 to 2028. About 15,000 individuals have been deployed to peacekeeping missions since 1963, but the number dwindled due to various issues. The country's peacekeeping forces now only stand at 28. The Foreign Affairs Department says being a party or part of the UN Council is essential to ensure the country's engagement in dialogues concerning peace and stability.
Well, we'll be able to engage in the most important dialogue and debates and vote even in important issues. We have, of course, an interest in the rule of law, international law, maintenance of peace and stability. It's very important. We have millions of Filipinos overseas, and we need the world to continue living and aspiring for the goals for which the UN was even created.
The Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines advises commercial pilots to avoid the airspace surrounding North Korea, South Korea, and Eastern Japan due to the planned satellite launch of Pyongyang. Kaap said in its notice to airmen that pilots should implement all safety precautions and refrain from entering the affected airspace from 8 a.m. on May 31st until 7:59 a.m. on June 11th. North Korea state media on Tuesday confirmed the country will launch a reconnaissance satellite in June. The move, according to a senior defense official, is aimed at monitoring military movements of the U.S. and its allies. The Philippine House of Representatives passes on third and final reading a bill declaring the country's maritime zones. These comprise of internal and archipelagic waters, territorial sea, continental shelf, and contiguous and exclusive economic zone. Lawmaker Rachel Arena said the measure will be beneficial in the country's pursuit of food and economic security, as well as promoting the Philippines' territorial integrity. The House will submit the bill to the Senate for action. Some Philippine senators still don't see the need for a sovereign wealth fund. This, even as the bill creating the fund was certified as urgent by President Marcos. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Karen de Guzman. Karen, good morning.
Good morning, Rica. More debates seen as the senator zooms the interpellation of the proposed Maharlika Investment Fund, or MIF, at the plenary session on Monday evening. Some senators questioned the president's urgent certification of the said bill. Senate Minority Leader Senator Coco Pimentel said that this can only be rushed if there's a public calamity or emergency. Senator Mark Villar, who is the main sponsor and author of the said bill, defended that this will address poverty, which is now considered as an emergency of the government. Pimentel also clarified the role and functions of the Maharlika Investment Corporation. Villar explained that the MIC is a GOCC with special vehicle for investment, creating more than 300,000 job opportunities, according to NEDA. He also added that MIC officials will be considered as public officials. Senator Lisa Hontiveros, on the other hand, said that the bill should clearly indicate penalties for MIC officials who will be involved in corrupt practices. Meanwhile, Pimentel expressed concerns over the utilization of the funds of the Land Bank of the Philippines and the Development Bank of the Philippines as initial capital of the MIF. He further questioned the motive of using the said idle funds of the government. Villar, however, sees this as investable funds, creating further growth in the social economic agenda.
Roadshow, and this is the third week that I've... Measure, Mr. President, to suspend the interpellation, Mr. President, so we can start tomorrow on a new topic, which is now defund.
Mr. President, I object. I think I've
I think we've debated this extensively. I've answered all the interpolations, and without prejudice to the amendments being proposed, I'd like to object and I'd like to move to close interpolations.
The first motion, actually, of the minority floor leader would be muted and academic because we recognize that it is the right of the sponsor to sit down if he or she so wishes and no longer be interpolated.
Voting 2-11, the Senate declares Pimentel's motion to continue inquiry on the MIF bill lost. Only Pimentel and Hontiveros voted in favor of the motion. Villanueva closes the period of interpolation and the period of amendments will resume today at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Rika?
Thank you so much, Karen de Guzman, reporting. The president's sister, Senator Amy Marcos, is among those worried over the proposed Maharlika Investment Fund. She admits, she isn't too keen on passing it. Key concerns for her are funding and the country's debts.
Kasi ang pagkaintindi ko, nagkakaroon ng sovereign fund kapag nag-jackpot. Pagka nagka-jackpot ang isang bansa, halimbawa, yung Malampaya sana, jackpot yun eh, nagkaroon tayo ng natural gas. Sana noon, nagka-sovereign fund. Sa ibang bansa, pag nakahanap sila ng oil, ayan, jackpot din. Ayun, when you get a windfall, that's usually the beginning of a sovereign fund. Eh, I don't feel any windfall right now.
Several political parties reaffirmed their alliance with the Lakas CMD party list following a leadership row in the House of Representatives. In a statement, the office of House Speaker Martin Waldes said at least seven parties signed an agreement with the Lakas CMD reaffirming their alliance. These include the PDP Laban, National Unity Party, and Nationalista Party. Under the agreement, the parties pledged to give their full and unqualified support to President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and to House Speaker Romualdez. Romualdez says it is a clear sign of their commitment to work together for the passage of the administration's pro-people legislative agenda. Rumors of a house coup surfaced last week, allegedly orchestrated by lawmaker Gloria Macapagal Arroyo after she was demoted to deputy speaker. She has denied that allegation.
The Philippine House Ethics Panel recommends stiffer penalties for embattled lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. But the Negros Oriental congressman urges his colleagues to be fair should they put their recommendations to a vote. RG Cruz has the details.
Emerging from a closed-door executive session, the House Committee on Ethics and Privileges recommends stiffer penalties on Negros Oriental 3rd District Representative Arnolfo Teves Jr., who remains outside the country without the nod of the House. The panel believes this is disorderly behavior because under the House rules, members must act in a manner that reflects creditably to the institution.
The Committee on Ethics and Privileges unanimously decided to recommend to the plenary the imposition of a stiffer disciplinary action to our colleagues, Arnolfo Alni Ativis Jr. for violation of the rules of the House of Representatives, particularly Rule 20, Section 142, Subsection A and B of the Code of Conduct, and for disorderly behavior.
But in a virtual press conference, Teves disputes this.
Anong disorderly conduct sa pag-absent? Disorderly conduct ko yung hindi ako sumunod sa kanila?
The panel did not allow full disclosure of the penalties, which means it won't be known till the plenary acts on the recommendation, on or before this Wednesday, when the 19th Congress adjourns its first regular session. But they rule out another suspension since their colleague already got the maximum 60-day suspension last March. However, for one panel official, this doesn't automatically mean expulsion.
Based on the House rules, the stiffer penalty from the suspension is expulsion. And there is another penalty that can be imposed. Any penalty that the committee may determine. So yun na lang po yung mga natitirang options. But I'm not saying that yun po yung decision or recommendation ng committee.
Disability Affairs Secretary General Reginald Velasco says Teves Jr.'s case is unprecedented, as those who have been dropped from the roles of the House in the past had criminal convictions, while Teves has only been charged for murder before the Justice Department. Bongalon also explained that expelled lawmakers can always run again. Should the plenary put the recommendation to a vote, Representative Tevez Jr. will have to wait till July 24 before he can appeal to his colleagues. Tevez has an appeal to his colleagues this early.
Bumoto tayo sa naaayon sa batas at naaayon sa ating puso. It should be a collegial, real collegial decision, hindi yung decision na galing lang sa mando ng iisa.
The panel did not grant Tevez's bid to join the proceedings electronically.
Wala naman akong warrant, wala naman akong kaso. Bakit ko kailangan magpakita physically? Unang-una, one-sided yan. This is a fact, di ba?
We really require the personal appearance, no, of our respondent. This committee has really the option, no, to really implement the whatever measures in order to protect the proceedings and how are we going to conduct our hearings.
Tevez's lawyer was also not allowed to face the panel in his behalf.
We will explore all legal avenues. We may go to the Supreme Court, we may go to the Ombudsman, we will see.
Hindi naman po talaga siya invited, no, dito sa Committee on Ethics, and he wanted to appear on behalf of Congressman Arnulfo Tevez.
The panel plans to submit its recommendation to the whole House before it adjourns the first regular session of the 19th Congress on May 31st. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.